I heard in the I read in the media, the honorable home minister saying that secularism is the word that was injected into the constitution, and therefore that is the cause of all problems. It is also referred to, I believe, poor old Amir Khan, our actor, is getting lampooned. He said Ambedkar did not leave the country, but he stayed here and struggled, and that is what Amir Khan also said, sir. Oh man, he didn't say that he's leaving. I am glad he's staying in struggle, and then you accuse them saying that left is sponsoring all that. Thank you for putting all those people with us. Our tribe is increasing. that you are doing it. But remember, Ambedkar did not leave the country. He was a patriot. But Ambedkar renounced Hinduism and embraced Buddhism. You remember that? You remember that? And why was it? That is where the intolerance issue comes in. And sir, these are matters again of history you cannot erase. And if you want the question of intolerance, take the same speech that the honorable leader was quoting of Ambedkar on 25th November. Same speech. And what did Dr. Ambedkar say?
One today.
He was talking about history will repeat itself. Will we lose our independence again? Honorable leader of the house quoted that. After that he didn't quote the rest of it. What does it say, sir? I'm quoting from that speech of Dr. Ambedkar. Will history repeat itself? Question mark. That is, will we lose our independence once again? Will Indians place the country above their creed? Or will they place creed above the country? I did not know. If, as the leader of the house said, if Dr. Ambedkar was here today, what would he say? He won't pose this question. He'll say Indians are being forced to place the creed above the country. And that is the intolerance that is happening in the country today. And then what does Dr. Ambedkar say? But this much is certain. This is a speech, sir, which was quoted in the morning. But this much is certain. If the parties place creed above country, our independence will be put in jeopardy a second time. After all the instances he gave, which was quoted by the leader, will be put in a jeopardy a second time and probably be lost forever. This eventuality we must all resolutely guard against. We must be determined to defend our independence with the last drop of our blood. Today, when I stand up against this intolerance, I'm doing exactly what Dr. Ambedkar asked us to do. Anybody who wants to say what Ambedkar said must be done, will do exactly what Dr. Ambedkar asked us to do, that is raise themselves against this sort of intolerance. This is the same Ambedkar in the same speech. And then we heard the question of social justice. The essential point of Dr. Ambedkar is missed out. I've quoted this a number of times in this August house, but I can't stop myself from quoting this again, that I'll quote it in the full. This is a point that I'll come to. I'll quote it in the full. It says, on 26th of January 1950, please note, again, once again, Constitution Day, the Republic Day, the 26th of January 1950, we are going to enter into a life of contradictions. In politics, we will give equality, and in social and economic life, we will have inequality. In politics, we will be recognizing the principle of one man, one vote, one value. In our social and economic life, we shall, by reason of our social and economic structure, continue to deny the principle of one man, one value. That is the contradiction. Then he continues to say what? If we continue to deny it for long, we will do so only by putting our political democracy in peril. We must remove this contradiction at the earliest, or else those who suffer from this inequality will blow up the structure of political democracy that this assembly hath so laboriously built. Unquote. This is Dr. Ambedkar in the same speech. What is the situation today? 100 multi-billionaires in our country whose asset value is close to one half of my country's GDP? And according to the latest census, 90% of the households in my country today have an income of less than 10,000 rupees a month. Is this contradiction being resolved, or are we only accentuating further? And are we discussing issues on how we should reduce the gap in this contradiction? Instead, every foreign trip, we find a new concession to foreign capital. 15 areas now that have been opened up to FDI. Free trade agreements that will ruin our domestic cultivation of commercial crops. Your agrarian distress is growing. Farmers are committing suicides. Your industrial production index, this government's own statistics, this month has shown a drop from 6.7% to near close to 3%. Manufacturing to 2.4% from over 6%. Industry stagnating or declining. Agrarian distress deepening. The social justice vision of Dr. Ambedkar, where are we? SCs and SCs, their subplans, their reservations, the atrocities on them I've mentioned. On the question of these growing inequalities, the conditions of our people, what is this contradiction that you see the reality? Are we paying homage to Dr. Ambedkar, sir? Is this the way modern India is actually fulfilling that vision of social justice?